Good afternoon, YouTube. I got a letter in the mail. Actually, I got it, I think, last Wednesday. Sorry, brother, I know it, what it is. I know who it's from, even though he posts his email, or he posts his address on his YouTube channel and doesn't post it on his return in, or doesn't put a return envelope. Doesn't put a return address on the envelope. So, this came in on Wednesday, and I have just been too busy to open it, shoot a video. More than one thing in there. Okay. So it is from JT Bear. In the coffee filter is seeds from the Saskatoon berries in his yard. And in the coffee, or in the paper towel are some dried berries. Thanks for being part of his adventure. All right, brother, I will get these in some soil later this afternoon, and say a little prayer to the gods of the garden. Now then, I have been remiss myself. I promised a garden update. So we've let our cold frame go wild. It has remember the lamb's quarters here going to seed. It has portulaca down at the bottom there going wild. That is green amaranth. Actually, I can get a closer picture of it over at the other side of the garden. That is a mystery squash that has come up out of the compost. These are the cabbages that came back from last year and are now setting heads. They have flowered and set seed. I've been letting the evening primrose and the fleabane grow wild. Come on, focus. Don't make me use an AV. So, you can see the leaves very clearly here, JT. Looks like the what you have growing in the corner there is definitely the amaranth that you planted. Now, this is, geez, near 5 feet tall, and theoretically the grain amaranth that you have planted should grow larger than the wild green amaranth that I have in my garden. We have tamarack coming up, looking good and healthy now. We had a bit of a drought for a week and a half here, and everything got kind of stunted. This is my Chicago hardy fig. It is not had spent a winter outside yet, and it won't this winter either. Trying to get drowned out by the wild yarrow, his little hens and chicks there. This is wild yarrow, wild goldenrod, which is a medicinal herb. We have wild white daisies and wild brown-eyed Susans in this. In here we have ground cherries. We have broccoli rub, red mustard greens, this is the tatsoi from Klangstar. Looking gorgeous. Black-seeded Simpson lettuce. I forget what these are. These must be beets. Yes, these are beets. And not a single one of the parsnips came up. This is my red onion bed. I always plant a few petunias in with the onions because of a nursery rhyme or kid's song that I learned 50 years ago. I'm a lonely little petunia in an onion patch. So I always plant petunias in with my onions. The onion patch has sort of gotten taken over by potatoes that came back from last year. There's another of the lamb's quarters here. Now that box is 2 feet tall. And that plant is sticking up easily 7 feet in the air. This is Georgia collards, purple basil, or the Claytonia is about done for the year. Hopefully it has reseeded itself. We've got some arugula coming up from seed that came from the arugula that came back and went to seed. Here is my Malabar spinach, a bunch of pak choy that's gone to seed, some dinosaur kale, some purple basil. These ginormous things back here are the spring onions from the grocery store that we cut into chives and then replanted the roots, so they did really well. This is one of our salad beds. Mystery lettuce at the front. It was one of those mescaline mixes. Some scarlet kale, some dinosaur kale, some pak choy. This is an area of the garden I don't think I have actually shown on camera before. We have horseradish here, Echinacea purpurea here, more horseradish back there, a snowball plant that I have got to get pulled out. I hate snowball plants. This is Jerusalem artichoke in here, another snowball plant, and then down at the end of this bed, more horseradish. This is all from two horseradish starts that I had got from Richter's Gardens. Oh, 22 years ago, I've been traipsing around the country, spreading bits of root here and there, getting them started. So, the permaculture orchard, we did not get any apples from our trees this year. The squirrels stole every single one of them when they were, when they got to be about the size of a large grape. The robins stole almost all of our cherries. So the pie plate trick does not work. Are you focused? We put some red plasticine fake cherries in the tree to make the birds think that maybe the cherries in this tree are no good to eat. That didn't work. We must have got about 200 cherries on the tree this year, and I think between us, my wife and I managed to eat a dozen or a dozen and a half. We got a weeping Siberian pea shrub as a gift from a friend. This is the small one, I guess, from Walmart. Our irises are kind of in need of weeding. Another apple tree that didn't give us any fruit, although it bore fruit. The squirrels got it all. The lupin bed is not looking too good because we've been in drought conditions here for a while. We had to completely screen in our strawberries this year. And the robins would land on top of the screen here and try to reach down through, and that's 2 feet high. Almost feel like putting a bounty out on robins and squirrels. This is a 5-in-1 tree. We got some flowers. I don't think it actually set any fruit at all. We had a... This is also the tree that I treated the tent caterpillars with the homemade nicotine spray, which worked really well, except that tent caterpillars make a layered nest, so I sprayed the nicotine spray in and it killed all the ones in the outer layer, and then you could see some movement further in, so rip into that and spray in there, and it was like trying to poison an onion with contact poison. But it eventually worked. This is ginger from the grocery store that we have growing in a wicking bed here. We got a few berries out of our hascaps, but only just a few, but those were all just planted this year too, so this is the Manchurian apricot tree that I picked up this spring. And we have gooseberries here. Ooh, look at the size of that. Now, I am 6.5 feet tall, and I take a size 16 or size 17 ring. And my battery is warning me it's going to die. So quickly, black currants are gorgeous. We had to do an emergency transplant of a bunch of wild blueberries. And we apparently transplanted some of the wintergreen as well. They've about died off with the drought we've been having, but they'll probably, at least some of them should come back next year. This is a female, and down there, a male, sea buckthorn, both a medicinal and a nitrogen fixing plant. Our mint bed is gone bananas as usual. Other mint bed has not quite gone bananas as badly. So there is our permaculture orchard at a glance. We do have some, I don't know whether they're actually called Uri pears or just U-R-E pears. These are about an inch and a half long right now. My apples didn't even get that big before the squirrels stole them all. We put up some decorative fence here by the flower garden bed, which we are trying to reclaim. It was full of these awful spirea. I dug out two wheelbarrow loads full of spirea from this area here. The Turk's head lilies are what we want to keep. Of course, we believe in providing food for monarch butterflies and their caterpillars, so we have been letting the milkweeds grow, and we have decided that this little triangle back here will be dedicated strictly to milkweeds. Take a look at these fence boards. These are all out of trees that grew here that I cut down and had cut up at the sawmill. Top one to me looks like a turtle's head coming out. A robin's head there. My stepdaughter says this one looks like a duck. Top one to me here looks like a sturgeon. We call it the wooden cloud wall. We have a 6 foot tall mullein growing in the side yard that I'm allowing to go to seeds, and maybe I can actually start some of that next year. This is an experiment this year. We have wild portulaca coming up and calendula flowers that were planted from seed. Raspberries, transplanted wild blackberries, transplanted purple flowering blackberries, grapes. Calico corn. Potatoes, Jacob's cattle bean, which is a soup bean. more of the lamb's quarters. Pak choi, turnips, radishes we've been harvesting. These were supposed to be pickling cucumbers, but you see that? They're about a foot long and 3 inches in diameter. Tomatoes are getting hit pretty hard by the drought right now. This is a test plot of feed grade barley that we just threw a couple of handfuls of seed in just to see if it would grow and what it would grow like. Sweet potatoes doing quite well. The squash down at the end, it looks like it's doing pretty good. Tomatillos are about 5 feet tall. And then this side is all Scotch bonnets. The other side is all ghost peppers. There's some Trolls cayenne down there. You can just barely see one green pepper there. There's some of the dragon cayenne I got from Rocco's TV over there. These are blue potatoes that just started sprouting in the basement. All the potatoes we planted this year are either stuff that came back by accident or started sprouting in the basement. The outside row here is Swiss chard. The inside three rows are pickling beets. And then the outside row on this side is Swiss chard. Two, three more garden beds as soon as we can afford to fill them with soil, because there is no soil here, it is all sand. Anyway, that's it for now, and thanks for watching.